Welcome to the video news of the week. On Wednesday, Colebrook Police report that after a year-long investigation, seven suspects, five females and two males, were arrested in a warrant sweep for selling prescription drugs, fentanyl, patches, mushrooms, acid, and heroin. The Colebrook Police were able to develop criminal informants throughout the year and use these informants to conduct controlled buys and illegal drugs in town. All seven suspects were held on cash bail pending arraignment. The Colebrook Police Department report that it is in the process of issuing more arrest warrants for the sale of illegal drugs and are anticipating more arrests stemming from the investigation. The Colebrook Police Department was assisted in the arrest by the New Hampshire State Police, the Coos County Sheriff's Department, and the Pittsburgh Police Department. On Tuesday, January 5th, 2016, the Colebrook Chronicle brought its camera south to catch up with the Donald Trump campaign at the Stevens High School in Claremont, New Hampshire. Over 1,200 people and 120 journalists were on hand to see Trump here, now just a month away from New Hampshire's first-in-the-nation primary. Among the reporters were a crew from Tokyo Television doing a report on the U.S. campaign. Just before the speech, Major Garrett from CBS News and Sarah Murray from CNN News prepared to go live with their reports. Behind the scenes, news producers and reporters kept in touch with home base. Security was tough for everyone who came in. Media had equipment scrutinized by bomb-sniffing dogs, and everyone went under the search wand. The gym began to look like a hockey arena as people began pouring in.
We need to show them tens of thousands of New Hampshire voters endorsing Donald Trump.
Once everyone was in the building, Republican presidential candidate Donald J. Trump came out and spoke to the capacity crowd.
Rates are going up 25, 35, 45%. Your deductibles are through the roof. You'll never get to use it. It's so out of control. I love saying that I spent less than anybody here, and my result is by far the best, because I'm up more than double. What, right? No, I love it because I'd love to see our country do that.
We got a problem. We got to solve the problem, folks. We got to clean up our borders. We got to let people come in. They have to come in legally. But you know, if you look at, we're going to build a wall, I'm going to build a real wall. Not a political politician wall. You know, years ago, they wanted a wall. And the politicians couldn't get it approved. You know why? They couldn't get, you won't believe this, an environmental income. Can you believe this? Every time I go, any place in New Hampshire, one of the first things that they talk about is the incredible problem they have with addiction and with the drugs. We're going to work on it. We're going to try our damnedest to get it done. But I'll tell you what, we're going to stop that crap from coming in. We're going to stop it.
When are we going to take our country back? That's the question. Are you ready? It's going to start on February 9th.
On New Year's Eve, Barry Berwick and Nancy Lloyd opened up their huge garage to welcome close to 100 family and friends to a New Year's Eve party. People started coming in, food in hand, around 8 p.m., and before long, the garage was full for a night of music.
I've been loved, and that was before my magic.
On December 30th, our Canadian correspondent Corey Bellum visited the Eric and Jane Molson Arena at Bishop's University in Lennoxville to find the rink covered with skaters of all ages enjoying an afternoon of fun.
The Colebrook Chronicle rang in the new year by attending First Night in St. Johnsbury, Vermont, the town's annual musical event for welcoming in the new year. Over 100 performers were on hand at venues all around St. Johnsbury, with the night's events culminating in a fireworks display at midnight.
Oh, my God.
The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating, over 85 years of local dependable service. Call 237-8301 for heating, plumbing, and electrical needs. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday's weather brings a high of 34 degrees. Saturday sees a chance of snow with a high of 36, and Sunday warms up a bit to a high of 43. The Colebrook Mohawks played host to the Woodsville Engineers in varsity basketball matchups on Wednesday afternoon. Watching the Video News of the Week.